Yeah, poles. It's revolutionizing the way that we think about snowboarding. Like an, you know, and I could just push on this flat part. Came from my background in epic mix racing. I was studying videotape of tapes of Lindsey Vonn, and I noticed every single race she started off with these poles, pole pushes, whoosh, whoosh, and I was like, wow, what if you could do that on a snowboard? So that night I went to the Brick Sports here and bought my first pair of poles. Yeah, after years of pole planting, I've got a couple little tips. For one, you don't actually want two of the same length poles. Skiers do, because they're facing the same way. For snowboarders, this side's a little farther of a reach, so when you got the same length pole, you're kind of off balance. So on the left side of my board, I use a 50-inch Rosignol. On the right side here, I use a 48-inch Good. Close one there. So it's really just when you're pole planting on those nice carves like that, it's really just more of a nice like fluid motion. You get that skier effect, push off mid-carve, push off, push off. You can really feel it through your body just flowing. And nowadays when I watch snowboarders come down without poles, I'm just like, how do they even do it? The way that I see it is there's really just two types of snowboarders. There's those that pole plant, and there's those that don't use poles. I'm Ryan Knapton. And I like to pole plant. Yeah, to tell you the truth, I've actually been called a lot worse than a nerd by the non-pole planting snowboard community. Whenever we're on the flats, they just eat my dust every time. Come on, Knapton, rock and roll!